Brix is just basically the soluble percentage of sugar by volume. So if a grape that you buy at the grocery store is about probably the same level of sugar content as grapes picked for champagne, 18, 19, 20 degrees Brix. So use the idea of a Thompson seedless as your baseline for about 20 Brix. Sugar in grapes, as it really a fully ripe wine grape, tastes more like sugar than or like candy than produce. Very, very extraordinarily sweet. So if you are wondering, are these grapes ripe? Chances are they're not ripe. I find that a truly ripe grape screams pick me. So Brix for me, 23, 24, barely over 24, is perfectly appropriate for picking my estate wine. Like I said, champagne, 19, 20. European wines, sometimes, you know, depending on, you know, Riesling can be down in the teens, all the way up to, you know, really ripe years in the Rhône, you may see 24 degrees Brix. Amador, when you're talking about, you know, really ripe Zinfandels, you may see 26, 27 degrees Brix. Generally, 0.6 is the conversion factor of Brix to alcohol. So if there's 10 degrees Brix, you have 6% alcohol. 20 degrees Brix is 12% alcohol, and so on. And there's a little bit of wiggle room in there depending on the yeast you use and such. Let's talk about pH. Well, without getting too geeky, pH is a measure of hydrogen ion activity in solution, which just means how fast are the little hydrogen ions flying around in the solution, which is very important to understand the mouthfeel of a wine. Low pH means more acidity, high pH means less acidity. But it actually is more of a measure of the activity, but it generally means low acid, high acid. And it's an inverse relationship with acid, so lower the pH, higher the acid. pH in white wine, like I said, probably like 3.2 to 3.3 is what I like in white wine. Nice structure, beautiful acid. Red wines tend, if a soft red wine is probably 3.5 to 4.0 pH, a red wine like Pinot Noir or Gamay that has more acid should be between 3.3 and about 3.6. So most wines you're tasting, if you think that are soft, are above 3.5 pH, and most wines that you're tasting that you think have good structure and acidity are probably under 3.5. So 3.5 is kind of where I separate a soft wine from a structured wine. Structure meaning acid, not by tannin. And then the last you asked about acid, well, acid is usually mostly malic acid and tartaric acid. Malic and tartaric have a relationship where malic has a bright appley flavor and tartaric is more the acid flavor that we're used to in wine, slightly minerally and slightly metallic. So the malic acid is usually removed from the wine by a bacteria, and the bacteria consumes the malic acid and excretes lactic acid, and the lactic acid gives the red wine a sort of soft, round kind of character to it. And it also mellows out acidic wines like Pinot, which taste very Gamay-like before they go through malolactic fermentation, end up being a little more seamless and a little more minerally, and not so brightly, purely fruit-driven. So I'm a big believer in malolactic for all red wines except Nouveau Beaujolais, and I'm a big believer in malolactic fermentation for Chardonnay, but not for Sauvignon Blanc. A lot of Rieslings, even in Germany, do go through malolactic. Chablis. Surprising, when I went to Chablis, I found out all Chablis also, almost all do go through 100% malolactic. There are some regions that make very soft Chardonnay that want to maintain acidity, so they make a non-malolactic Chardonnay. But I think the process of taking the malic acid out and promoting lactic acid in the wines I make is vital to the mouthfeel and what's happening. And it changes the acid structure a little bit as well. But acid is measured in the weight of the acidity in the solution, as opposed to pH, which is a measure of the activity, the ion activity within the solution. So acid is fixed, pH is actually about activity, and I think it's, if you're going to understand acidity or pH in wine, pH is the way to go because it influences more in the way that the wine tastes and the way the wine reacts to your taste buds.